Scab of potato. In case of scab of potato, this is a bacterial disease. This disease occurs throughout the world. It is most prevalent and important in neutral and slightly alkaline soil and light sand soil is suitable for growing of this particular crop and as well as their disease symptomology. In India, since 1976, that disease has become widespread in the plains of Uttar Pradesh, Haryana and Punjab. When we are discussing about this causal organism of this disease is Streptomyces scabies. The vegetative form consists of slender, branched, aerial, grey-colored mycelium you can find here, with a few or no cross walls in the mycelium. And the conidiophore are branched, septate, spirally coiled with terminal branches are found about this casual organism. Symptoms. The symptoms of a common scab of potato are seen mostly on tubers. There are two types of lesion form. One is a shallow scab and second is a deep scab. Whereas in case of shallow scab, in shallow scab, affected tubers are shown superficial roughened areas, sometimes raised above and often slightly below the planes of healthy skins here. The lesions consist of corky tissue with a rise from the tuber peridot. The lesions are barker than the healthy skin compared to the healthy skin here, very much darker characteristics we can find here. In case of disease cycle, this can spreading through the soil water, wind-blown soil, and infected potato seed tubers. The pathogens penetrates the tissue through lenticles, wounds, stomata, and in young tuber directly also. It is young tuber directly also happens very rarely. After penetrate, the pathogen grow between or else through a few layers of cells. The cells die and the pathogen then lives off as a saprophyte particularly. The disease can develop in temperature about 11 to 30.5 degrees centigrade. Disease management, how to control this disease means. The tubers can disinfectate by dipping them for 5 minutes in 0.25 suspension of mercurial fungicides such as MSN 6, agalol or atoms. Green manure also suggestible. Using resistant and tolerant varieties are useful for the protecting of this disease. Thank you very much for the listening of this disease information.